Hey there, for the CAD Geek, I'm Donnie Gladfelter, and today I'm checking out one of my favorite new features inside of AutoCAD 2018.1, and that is the new View and Viewport functionality. Now, before I get into that, just in case you're not too familiar with this 2018.1 update thing, this is available as a free download, either from the Autodesk desktop application or by jumping over to the Autodesk account website. It doesn't matter where you download it. Once you've downloaded and installed it on your machine, you're going to have all sorts of great new features and functionality added to AutoCAD 2018 and its vertical derivatives. Among them is this new View and Viewport functionality, which I absolutely love. So the scenario here is I have my floor plan, as you can see in this drawing, and I would like to create a view that I could then place at a specific scale on a plan sheet or layout tab. So in 2018.1, the way I'm going to accomplish that is by jumping over here to the view tab in the ribbon. And what I'm gonna see is a new panel here called Named Views. And on that panel, there is going to be a button here called New View. Now, this is actually a brand new sort of button to the interface, at least. And the way I know that is because it has this little orange circle or dot next to it. This is something that you can turn off if it completely annoys you just by coming over here to the Info Center toolbar. You can disable the highlight new features. You'll notice the dots go away. I happen to like the dots, so I'm going to keep them turned on. Regardless of your preference about dots or no dots, I'm going to go ahead and click here into the new view tool. This typically opens up collapsed like you see here. So this is pretty simple. I can do something like type in overall floor plan, like so. And I can either choose to use the entire display window as it's shown right here, or kind of refine things down a little bit with the define window option right here. If I click on define window, I'm just gonna draw a box around my area of interest, being the entire floor plan in this case. I can hit enter and click OK and a view would be created. If I desire a little more control over just these basic options, I can expand this dialog out and get some additional options right there. We're not going to bother with any of those, so I'm just going to go ahead and click OK. And with that, I have a new view in this drawing called Overall Floor Plan. So what can I do with that? Well, to answer that question, I'm going to jump now over to this layout tab in my drawing called A100. And what I can do now is if I come up here to the layout contextual ribbon tab that opens up, you've probably seen the rectangular viewport option here for quite some time. That's been on this layout tab pretty much since its inception. But what's new is this new insert view option right here. If I click the down arrow here, I get a nice gallery view of all of the views in this particular drawing. I only have one right now, and so I can click on the overall floor plan in this case, and notice my command prompts. I can specify the view location, or I can actually right click and figure out what scale will actually fit on this sheet. So can 3/32 fit? As it works out, it doesn't look like it can. So if I just right click again, we'll just come down to this 1/16 size and go ahead and place that right there on my drawing. And just like that, the view is placed. Now, what's really awesome about this isn't just sort of your standard sort of static viewport. There is some intelligence to this. In fact, if I pick this up, I can pick things up from the grip in the very middle here and move this view wherever I'd like on my plan. I also have this little scale selector option here as well. And so even after the viewport is placed or the view is placed, I can still come back and change its scale just like that. And for those of you who know best practices with viewports, yes, this is a locked viewport. Now, that's pretty awesome, but what if I needed maybe a close-up of maybe this little cube gathering right here? Do I have to go to model space? Actually, no. You could and go through the workflow that I just showed, or one of the other options we have here is right here from this layout ribbon tab. I'm just gonna go ahead and pick right here where it says new view. This will actually take me back to model space, or at least kind of this model space-like window for just a moment. And I can go ahead and just draw a box around the area that I wanna create kind of this detailed view of. I'll hit enter, And in just sort of one fell swoop, I can place that right there in my drawing. I get all the same options that I did with the other viewport, and the way that I can come in here and change the scale of this after the fact, I can move it, I can do any of that I would like very quickly and easily. So there you have it, just a very quick look at the new view and viewport functionality added to AutoCAD 2018.1. Once again, you can download this update either from the Autodesk desktop application or by jumping over to the Autodesk account website and downloading it there. I'll leave a link to the Autodesk account website in the description below. But with that, let me know what you think about this, or if you have any other questions about the 2018.1 release, and I'll be happy to answer them down in the comment section below. Once again, for the CAD Geek, I'm Donnie Gladfelter. Thanks so much for watching.